Hello everyone. So already we have talked about the metal ion electrode and this glass electrodes in my previous videos. So now we'll see the other electrode like quinine hydron electrode. So it is introduced by the E. Bilban in 1921 and it is an inert electrode usually of platinum or gold deep in into the unknown solution to which a pure solid quinine hydron has been added until the solution is saturated. So quinine hydron is a 1:1 molar compound of quinone and hydroquinone. So it provides equimolar quantities of quinone and hydroquinone in solutions. Advantage of this using quinone hydron electrode is like equilibrium is established quickly. It is not so easily incapacitated as hydrogen electrode. It is less expensive than a glass electrode, and then it can be employed in many solutions in which the hydrogen electrode cannot be used, like some example of zinc solution, copper solution, cadmium, neon solution, etc. It has a low resistance, it gives a rapid response, and it is not affected by the presence of reducing gases. And it can be used for accurate micro determinations, and it is used not affected by the dissolved oxygens, and these advantages are also there. So it cannot be applied to the solution more basic than pH of 9 because the hydroquinone being weak acid is neutralized by the base. It is not stable for a long time, particularly above 303 Kelvin. So strongly oxidized oxidizing reducing agent should be avoided. Disadvantages are there for this quinone hydron electrode. Next electrode we have antimony electrode. It is consists of a stick of metallic antimony cemented into a hard rubber sleeve, and an invisible surface coating of antimony oxide seems always to be present. And the solutions in which the antimony electrode is used should preferably contain dissolved air. If this electrode is dipped into an unknown solution, the potential of antimony and antimonous oxide system will depend on the hydrogen ion concentration according to the equilibrium. The reaction I have given here for the equilibrium, here you can see. So like antimony electrode, some advantage, it can be used to measure the pH of the solution ranging from 3 to 12. Since the electrode is not fragile as a glass electrode, it is useful for industrial purpose also, and it can be used as a probe for viscous solution. So different type of disadvantages are also there. So it cannot be used for solution having pH value lower than 3 and more than 12, and its potential is affected by the dissolved oxygen, composition of buffer solution, and movement of electrolyte. It is not useful in the presence of oxidizing and reducing agents. The different type of disadvantages is also there. Here you can see. Thank you.